So I'm attaching this fence at 5.2 from my center line here, because that's what it is. I'm measuring to the center line where I've got the little red circle. And I'm going to attach a fence. The only reason that this is long is because I've had this piece of plywood, this half inch piece of plywood, for years. And I use it all the time, and I'm not going to cut it for this. So I don't mind if it's long. It'll be just fine. So I'm going to put some 5/8 inch screws up through the bottom here. 3 ought to do it. And once it gets pinned down, this is just a guide, and then I'm gonna pin the plywood down. That's perfect. Okay, so what I'm gonna try to do here is I'm gonna try to do this in a manner in which I'm going to try to have 2 clamps on it at all times. Let me go ahead and just flip this over. Now, I don't want to drop the heavy router here. So I think now you can get an idea of what this is going to do. So I'll be able to just run it along the edge and reference off of my mark on the other side. So I can see my mark over here. I transferred my mark up to this side. So all I have to do is come over here, line my center mark up, which I guess I didn't do it on this side. Let me adjust that and do that. I just have to split the difference. This is, just put my mark right here in the middle. This is 20 millimeters here. This one, and that's not going to reach, so I'll get a big hand screw and reach up underneath here. But what I was saying is that I want to do it to where, as I'm advancing over, I can actually use the holes that I produce to stick one of my Festool clamps. Like this, down into the hole, and as I'm advancing over, I can let the hole pattern that I'm creating help me finish this job. So that's good. Now that can't move. It's aligned here, so that's good. So let me plug my vacuum in and hook this up, set my depth. I can do that right now. So you bring your router bit down. And I want to be careful, because I don't have a backer on the back. I want to be careful not to just be a maniac here. So you loosen this up, let it fall down, and you tighten it. Now you bring this down to zero. This thing slides, and so you bring it to zero. And I know that I've got, I know that I'm already at sitting right on top. I've got a 16th of an inch plus 18 millimeters, so I'm at a solid 3/4, so I'm gonna go like 21 millimeters. That ought to be enough. And as I get far down towards the post, I'm gonna keep plunging and coming up. So I want to be able to free and evacuate those chips, so I'm not gonna get overheated, and it's not gonna glaze the inside of my hole too much. And I don't want to bust through the bottom either. That's the other thing. I don't want to make a big mess and bust through. Okay, so I'm going to get suited up. I'm going to put on my apron, gloves, face shield, earplugs, and safety glasses underneath my face shield. Just because I want to be absolutely safe. And I'm going to stand on this side. So I'll move the camera, but I'm going to stand on this side. And I'm going to put a board in front of this, just in case the router bit does decide that this is the time that it's going to shatter. At least I've got that board that will, put an 8/4 board of mahogany, something short and stout in front of it that will act as a backstop for that shattered bit. So let me get suited up here, and I'll make a cut. Okay, so I have my leather apron, my My family jewels are below the tabletop level, so I'm not going to risk that. I've got eye protection on and a face shield. Gloves, I'm not going to hold the router down here in case it does blow. I'm going to, once I turn it on, I'm just going to operate it from the top in case it does blow. And I've got this stout piece of, mahogany here to act as a shield too. So let's see what happens. I probably shouldn't have pushed quite so hard at the end. I kind of felt it bump a little bit, but it's okay. So let me just shift this down. And so all I have to do now that I have this fence on here is all I have to do is look at my next. I just have to look at my next line and my reference mark on my plywood. Make sure that I'm up snug. And so this, I don't need this guy right now. In a minute, I'm going to use these rapids. They're just so much easier for me to manipulate. Keep a little WD on this guy. So I'm going to be careful and not push so hard this time. This bit, this is so much better than what I was doing with that box and that other thing. I'm going to cut one more and then I'm going to stop and I'm going to wait for that Festool bit. I've had this like this for 20 years and I can wait a couple weeks until Andy gets my bit to me. I'm not going to have a fit and, you know, get all impatient and, you know, I'd like to save this bit because I need it for, you know, my cabinet work. I'll cut one more and then I'm going to stop because it really is not really the appropriate bit for this. And I can take this out. I need this router for something else, but I'll just set this setup aside without breaking it down. I don't need it. And it'll be ready when that bit shows up. So I got my mark here to my reference line. I'm all dialed in. let's take a look at them, and let me unplug this router first. I don't want that thing plugged in. Yeah, but that's all I'm going to do. I'm not going to do any more with an inappropriate bit. But I just wanted to give you an idea right now, because the plans are coming out for the new Ultimate Work Table, and I just wanted to keep people from expending so much energy doing it the way I did in that video. I'm going to leave that in that video with that plywood box, because that plywood box has some other really useful applications. I don't have a mag drill when I'm doing steel work, and sometimes I've wanted to drill some big holes with a hole saw, and so I can put a big hole saw in that Hilti, and you know, something that I can't get on my drill press, like through a I-beam or something like that. And that Hilti has got the power if it's held properly, but you can't drill freehand with big hole saws in thick steel without, in a drill like that, I mean, you'd break your arm. That thing would, you get it just cocked ever so slightly, and there's so much material down in the steel, and that's not going to give. Wood will give a little bit. You get that thing racked, and that thing will come around, and it'll hurt you. So that drill box has been fantastic for, in a pinch, when I've had to drill some big holes in steel.